Glenn Kelly, which is Executive Vice President of Orbit. Mr. Kelly, you can hold on the microphone.
Thank you.
So, and is also Chief of Exploitation of Orbit. So, we just ended your annual meeting there, Mr. Kelly. So, what is your feeling about the investors' mood?
I think it went relatively well. The investors showed up with a lot of questions, rightly so. As you know, we had some issues with the construction of our first high-purity aluminum facility, but we've addressed those. We've put the corrective measures into place, put some new people in the organization, including myself, to help Orbit go from a technology development firm to an operating entity. And that's a big step, a step that is often underestimated, and I think Orbit erred on that side also. But I think the message the shareholders were comforted today to see that we're doing the right things to get this going back in the right direction.
I was present there in the room, and I could see that the most of the shareholders were a little bit anxious about the results, you know, and we know that the company had some problem. The company is also looking for money right now, and it's not an easy market right now to be looking after money, because all of the industry is looking for money at the moment.
True, but a couple things. I think the investors, you're saying we had some problems. We've addressed those problems. They know what they are. But you're saying the whole industry is looking for money, but not all of the industry has a great technology like Orbit. Mm-hmm. Yes, we have to go back to the markets, and we will be doing so when the moment is right, and we're quite confident.
And there's only one thing that I've missed over there. I didn't understand really well, because I had to go back and forth from this location here. And what is the cash flow situation at the moment? So are you clear for the next few months to come?
Oh, yes, we are. Yes, we are. I'm trying to recall what we was in our last published numbers. I've only been with the company for 3.5 weeks, so I haven't seen all of the information, but we're clear for the next months for sure. Where we need to raise additional capital is to finalize the high purity aluminum facility, and we showed today that we need another $31 million and another year to finalize that facility. But all of that, these are growing pains. This has nothing to do with the underlying technology. It's still very solid.
And what about the production, as you are in charge of the production there? Orbit was supposed to produce like 1 ton per day, mm-hmm. and now they're like a few pounds per day. So when do you expect to have the company on cruising speed?
Okay, the 1 ton per day or around that was produced when we started up the facility.
Yep.
And we had some issues with what we call the back end of the plant, or the calcination system. And instead of investing to try and correct those issues, we decided to take a step back and change the system that we bought. That will bring us to 3 tons per day by mid-2014. And while we're doing that, we're going to do the engineering analysis to bring the facility to 5 tons per day. Find out where we can debottleneck and how much that will cost to bring it to 5 tons per day. But to use your terms, when will we be cruising? That should be mid-2014.
Okay, because what you did actually, you stepped back in order to jump a little bit higher.
Definitely, and invest the money wisely and in the right places.
Okay, and what about the red mud there? Is there a, we don't know yet a lot about the deal with Veolia. And is there anything moving this way there? What about China? Where are they going to build new mills? And you have any information about that?
Sure we do. And I shared some of that this morning. The partnership with Veolia is moving forward quite rapidly. One of the things we did is evaluate and focus on or find the four, what we found to be the four promising sites with Veolia together. That's behind us. Now we're building a model to analyze technically and economically which one of those sites would be the best place for the first plant. That'll be finished by the end of this year, and then together we're going to be making the decision in the beginning of 2014 where are we going to focus with them. Parallel to that, we still have to finalize a joint vehicle with Veolia that will be doing the investing and the developing of this first plant. So that's going to be negotiated also in the beginning of the new year.
So the big promising year seems to be 2014.
I don't want to put too much hype or big words, but definitely we have a lot on the table. Finalization of the HPA facility, moving forward or advancing our relationship with Veolia, and I'd say recently and very important is the deal we signed with Glencore, which will accelerate or catalyze our SGA program, which is the smelter grade alumina. And just recall, I mean, you couldn't ask for a better partner in that business than Glencore. They've committed to buying the 10 first years of production out of our first facility, and they've also shown interest to invest in that facility with us, and those negotiations should get going sometime in 2014 also.
Well, that's encouraging. I mean, if they want to buy the production, they may as well invest in it.
And actually, it's yes. And
so is this one of the opportunities you're looking at right now for incoming money?
I'd say in the coming year, in 2014, but it's a normal business model. Very often you'll see that the off-taker, or the one that's buying the production, will also invest in the facility. And so we finalized the off-take agreement with Glencore. Now we're going to sit back with them and look at how they could invest in the facility.
Like what we see very often in gold production, we see companies that are buying in advance some of the production at a lower price, but that provides a very nice money for the company as well.
True, that's not the case with us buying at the lower price. We have a very competitive pricing formula that we've arrived at with Glencore. I think the good thing for us is they're committed for 10 years. Just that will help us finance a facility. When you have a partner of that credibility and that balance sheet, taking your product for 10 years. And for them, I think it's a recognition that we could be the low-cost player on the market, and they want to tie up that low-cost supply and make sure that we don't affect the stock price, the spot price for alumina. So I think it's a win-win situation for both companies.
And what about, again, Veolia? Are they going on their own there in the production of the mills for those red mud piles they have all over the world, or Orbit will participate into the construction of those mills?
Right now everything's on the table. We're working together in the pre-feasibility analysis, and once we have to decide how we'll move forward, everything is still open. We could be doing it jointly with Veolia, investing in the facilities, investing in the joint venture, or other formulas also. And that we'll start discussing with them at the beginning of 2014.
So I saw one of the biggest concerns of the shareholder was about transparency. And what is the Orbit point of view about that? Is that something you'd like to be like proactive in being more transparent in the time to come, because the investors seems like they were saying we don't know enough, we want to know more about what's going on?
Well, I won't comment on the past, but maybe you saw my last slide, and the last two bullets were going forward, transparent and timely communications, and that's one of the reasons I joined Orbit, and that's one of my mandates is to make sure that our communications with our make sure our operations evolve towards an operating entity or operating company, and ensure that we are communicating in a much more timely and transparent fashion with our shareholders. Ultimately, the objective is to gain the credibility back that we have lost, and I'm sure we will gain it back through our actions and not through our press releases or our words. We'll follow up with our actions.
Mr. Kelly, we thank you very much for your time, and we look forward to see whatever comes up on Orbit, and a lot of our viewers are shareholder of yours,
okay.
And that's our job to keep them informed. So thank you very much
for coming
by.
Thank you very much, and I look forward to speaking to you again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll give you back the puck, Chris.